Hey guys, welcome to Sidetracked. I'm Louis Sharp, this is Leah Kimple, and today we've got our album of the week, but we're doing something a little bit different with it, and then our guest this week is going to be American Absinthe. So Leah, you want to explain what's different about this week's album?
Cool, yeah. So if you guys remember in the first episode, we talked about our top albums of 2016, and we talked about How to Be a Human Being by Glass Animals. So we wanted to do more in an informative segment and kind of talk about why this album is so special, because we kind of learned more about it since that episode, and we just have some cool stuff that we wanted to share with you guys. Mm-hmm.
So, you guys want to show? sort of a concept album, right? What did he do? He went and like interviewed a bunch of people and like recorded mm-hmm. the conversations with them, and then characters around them?
So pretty much what's going on is each character that's shown on the album here is they all represent one of the songs on the album, and they all have their own stories, and the head of the singer for the band, his last name is Bailey, I can't think of his first name right now, but he like had all these stories from all these different people, and he was like talking to all these people, and he said, why don't we, when we make the album, let's like make it like a story type thing, and he like ended up creating all these different characters, and they all have their own stories, and it's just like, I just think it's like one of the neatest things ever that you can do with an album.
Yeah, no, that's really cool. And so each of the music videos for the songs kind of corresponds to and like tells the story of one of those characters.
Yep. So they've done the first couple songs. I know they've done Life Itself, Pork mm-hmm. Soda. I think they did season 2, episode 3. I think the next one that's going to come out is, I think it's going to be Mama's Gun. And that's my favorite. That's one of my favorite songs on the album. So I'm really excited for that one.
It's like a recent addition. I remember that wasn't on there
for
last time. So what made that one bump up in particular?
So what happened was my other favorite was Pork Soda. And I think mm-hmm. what happened is that I just kept listening to Pork Soda so many times that I was like, all right, I'm not tired of it by any means, because it's still a really great song. But I listened to Mama's Gun and I was like, oh, this song, like, it needs to be bumped back up there. So
Pork Soda is kind of like the worst song to like over listen to, because it's mm-hmm. so catchy too that like then you just like for the rest of your life will just be pineapples are like forever. Like,
forever pineapples are burned into my brain, and that's, you see a pineapple now and you're like, oh, Glass Animals.
Yep. And then I see Agnes. Mm-hmm. I think we can agree there.
You know, I recently noticed the Buzz was giving Agnes more time on the air. They were talking mm-hmm. about Agnes, and then they were playing it more, and I was like, that's the song I picked from the very beginning. I was like, that's the best one on there. Mm-hmm. But I feel like everyone's going to be jamming to that one pretty soon.
Yeah. It's my favorite song on the album. I really like season 2, episode 3 as well.
Yeah, I like
I don't know, Agnes just has that, like, I don't know, like, it's got these like rich kid kind of vibes mm-hmm. to it, like not caring about anything.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's got this like really cool feel. Like, I really dig being.
No, I dig it a lot. Mm. But so I'm pretty sure that from the way they've been releasing the music videos that they're making, they're like doing it in the orders of what the tracks are. So mm-hmm. Agnes is going to be last. So we have to wait so long for Agnes. But I'm still super excited about it. It's like, it's going to be like Christmas when it finally gets released. I'm going to be so excited.
It's going to be like Christmas. Well, at this rate, it is going to be like Christmas, like time period wise too.
But yeah, that's.
All right. So let's move to some like general thoughts on the album, because we definitely like talked about it, but you know, has your perspective on it in the past few months changed? Or I know your songs have, so.
The songs have. I feel like every time I go through and listen to the album, I feel a different way. Because when I first listened to it, I was just like, oh, this is really groovy and I can like get into it. And now when I listen to it, I'm like, there's so many layers to it. And it's just.
Layers. Layers. Really?
Apparently every album has layers to me. But it's like every time I listen to it, I just feel a different way. And I think that, I mean, that speaks a lot about an album. If it can like tap into all these different emotions every time you listen to it, then it must be, you know, it's mm-hmm. a work of art, I think.
I love the every time I forget, because I hadn't listened to it in probably a month, and mm-hmm. then you were like, oh, let's do this week, and so I re-listened to it, and I forgot the I don't know, weird assortment of instrumentation. Mm-hmm. Like, there's like the whatever those drums are that have like the beads in them that shake.
Yeah.
There's like, you can hear those, and then like the synths are so weird.
It's a really unique album.
Yeah, if nothing else, that is, they have a unique sound. Like, even other people you know, like Alt-J, for instance, they're kind of from similar area geographically, kind of trying to do the same thing. And
it's funny that you mentioned Alt-J, because I read an article the other day that said that this album, that Glass Animals in general, was like Alt-J, but on a beach playing the bongos. It's like, all right, I guess I can kind of see that.
Yeah, oh, for sure.
But definitely, since we've both seen both of them live on the same day, you know, I mean, it's just, it's really relevant.
Yep. Yeah, so I really dug the album. Let's do... We've done this every other time. Mm-hmm. I feel like you're going to put this thing like way high on a scale of 10.
This is a 10. I'm sorry.
It's a 10?
Yeah, it's all a right. 10 for me.
I don't know. I don't really know if I'd put it like... I'm about to break your heart. It's like a 7.
A 7?
It's like a 7.
All right. Well, it's your opinion.
All right, guys. We're going to throw it to a commercial break. And when we come back, we're going to do an interview with America's last great jam band, American Absinthe.
Introduce themselves and then say what they do within the band.
Hey, I'm Chris. I'm the lead guitarist and lead singer.
Hello, my pseudonym is C. Lemons, and I don't actually do anything or know any of these people.
I'm Kelly. I'm the bassist.
I am Christian, and I play guitar.
I'm Matthew, and I play percussion.
All right.
It's great to have you guys on the show today. We're super excited to see you play and everything.
We're super happy to be here.
Absolutely.
Yeah, even tech issues aside,
yeah.
I know that we, you know, this interview was a long time in the making. I'm excited to finally...
The perils of modern technology, I understand.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's always a struggle. So why don't you guys get started telling us kind of how you met, how you guys got started playing music and becoming musicians?
Well, I've known Cody and Matt from day one of UCM. They've been with me from the get-go. Kelly and I have been dating for over 4 years now, and she's been a good bassist. For how long?
Like a year and a half or so.
Okay, and then I met Christian the second I moved into the music technology program, and he's the only reason I'm still in school and not failing all my classes.
What a guy.
Everybody has one.
But that's how we all met. We all came together. We used to have another drummer, and he ended up leaving, and we decided we just wanted our best friend Matt to be in the band. High five.
I picked up a pair of drums one day off of Craigslist, and lo and behold, here I am.
Here we have our very American band.
Yeah.
Shout out to Craigslist right there.
Fueling the modern band camp.
Yep. Awesome. So how would you guys describe the music that you play?
How would you describe it as? Ooh, well, pass in everything.
I'd like to describe it as almost every American genre out there. We look at ourselves as an American jam band. Therefore, all the American songs you can think of, we try to fit in this like half-step feel mentality in almost all of our songs. And we do everything from funk to blues to jazz to... We just work it all in. Any other notes on our own personal sound, guys?
From my perspective, I feel like we've always tried to capture the kind of feeling that you get from listening to 60s and 70s music, a music that's very free and open, and there's a lot of possibility within it. You never know exactly where it's going to go, but you know it's going to follow a specific path. And I really think we like to take that, the kind of feel from that music, and combine it with a modern technology to create our own kind of sound.
Mm-hmm.
It's a mixture of ideologies from the past and present that I think really gives us our volume and our feel.
Okay.
It's really cool. It's a cool way to describe it.
Yeah, I like that. So what kind of music do you guys listen to, and did that have like an impact on the music that you started making?
Well, I specifically am really into the Grateful Dead, and that's always had a really big impact on my guitar playing. But I feel like everybody else brings their own little bit to the band to make it even more diverse.
Yeah, I would say the three of us give the band kind of the grungy feel, and he keeps us in check. Because... all of us kind of have influences like
punk rock,
nice,
like anything from hard rock to alternative rock, and then he's just over here with his jam bands and stuff. And somewhere where the two meet, there we are.
What can we expect you guys to be like listening to in your cars when you're driving home today?
A lot of heavy metal.
Heavy metal, nice.
Green Day,
nice.
The Foo Fighters?
I can respect pretty that. Big awesome. Spread. Yeah, yeah.
Only this band. This is the only band you should ever listen to. American Absinthe. I play it till my ears bleed and my eyes too.
What a hype man you are.
We love our Tom Petty and our Red Hot Chili Peppers
Petty.
Too.
Okay. Man, for Tom sure. Petty.
It's a good spread. I like that. The diversity. It definitely makes sense with your sound and stuff too. Mm-hmm.
Definitely. Cool. So, do you guys have any projects that you're working on right now?
We're currently throwing a two-show concert series up at Cave Hollow Park at the very end of Gay Street. They're both happening on Saturdays, April 1st and 8th at 5:30. And to be honest, they're completely sponsored by us. We have another band opening with us called the Gateway Dreamers. They're friends of ours, but they're awesome. But alas, here we are. We're trying to get ready for those and sponsor those ourselves, and it's just a bunch of work for us.
Any sort of like recording projects or?
Oh, I mean, we're always recording. We're still trying to come out with our first album. Always okay. Working on it, but I mean, school.
Yeah. Oh, of course. Yeah.
Yeah, like we're all in different majors, so our times of availability and productivity are always going to be varied. So we try to meet.
Oh yeah. It's definitely a struggle. Like I have plenty of friends that are in bands, and especially if you go to a different school, at least you guys have that. You know, you're all in Warrensburg.
So student athletes, student band members, always grinding.
That is true. So what about in the future, though? Like, you know, maybe you're even 5-10 years down the line, you guys have any big aspirations with American Absinthe?
Well, it's always been my baby. So I'm sure you might hear American Absinthe around for a while because I'm a music tech student. That's what I'm going for. I'm going to try to make it. We also got our other music student, Christian, over here. And I can't foresee any time when he's going to put down a guitar. So, yeah. I mean,
well, I'm glad to hear you guys were real good. That'd be a shame.
I kind of work day by day, though, so I never really look that far ahead.
Oh, yeah. I hate when... It's kind of hypocritical, because I hate when people ask me that question, like, where do you see yourself in however many years? But, you know, we had somebody on, like, a week ago that was... He seemed pretty sure, so... Yeah, some people, I guess, have an eye for that. And
we actually plan to establish our own country in 5 years as well.
All right.
Same flag.
Yeah.
American Absinthania.
Nice.
Look out for it.
Dig it. Go ahead.
All right, so where can we find... You said you're working on recording an album, but are there recordings and stuff available of your music?
Currently, you can find our stuff at our Facebook page. We're working on getting a website together and finalized so that we can post music on that. But we do have all of our music posted, well, our current music posted on our Facebook page. Definitely accessible. We have SoundCloud.
SoundCloud
on
too?
On Facebook at American Absinthe. If you can't find it, go find Christopher Hippie Davis. That's me. Totally. Add me on Facebook. I'll help you out.
Awesome. All right, so I got one last question for you guys, okay? It's going to be a tough one. If you guys could each jam with one band, one musical artist, or whatever, alive or dead, who would it be?
Well, I'd probably jam with Jerry Garcia from the Grateful Dead.
Rest in peace.
These people around me right now, love them. They are geniuses.
I'm going to either go with the Foo Fighters again or say Zeppelin because I think that'd be pretty
Zeppelin.
Fun.
Zeppelin. I dig Zeppelin.
Without a doubt in my mind, Pink Floyd.
Pink Floyd.
Still going to be Green Day.
Awesome.
Yeah.
I don't know.
You have anything else planned?
I don't. That's all I have. All
right, guys. Well, is there anything you guys want to close this thing off with?
Thanks for checking us out. We're American Absinthe. We hope to see you all at the shows if you come. And if not, we hope to see you. Anyways, yeah. Check out our stuff on Facebook. You know, I'm Chris, and this is my band, American Absinthe. It's been real great to be here today.
All right.
Thanks, guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course, we're always looking for people. All right, we're going to throw this to a quick commercial break. When we get back, we're going to hear some sweet tunes.
America and her people, I have a very special presentation for you. This is an amalgamation of the best people in history. This is American Absinthe. Please check us out on Facebook. And we don't have a Twitter, but if we did, you should look at that too. Enjoy the show.
Thank you. Kentucky. Can't live with Uncle Joe. Lord, I'm feeling trapped here.
Guys, we're American Absinthe. We came to rock you today. Glad to be here. That song you heard was Going to Kentucky. It was our first ever original song, and you got to hear it here live. We're going to play another original for you, and I hope you like it.
All right, guys. All
thank you.
That song was called